To find all these potential zeros, we know that for each one, we're going to take a factor of negative 13 and divide it by a factor of 2. Then we need to take the positive and negative versions of each of these ratios. So we could have 1 over 1, which is 1, or the negative version of that, negative 1. 13 over 1, which is just 13, and negative 13 as well. In the end, we come up with 8 roots that the rational zero theorem tells us this function might have.